Jayaha, Shivara Jaya here from vitalcoaching.com. The topic for this video is pact of non-aggression for couples. If you have been in a relationship, you know that sometimes there are lots of fights kicking in. There is lots of tension. There is aggression and resentment and triggers and so on. So in this conflict zone, in this fight zone, this might create lots of tension between the two of you and sabotage a lot of the harmony, the peace that you might be feeling. It sabotages as well your ability to function. You know, normally if you have been fighting in the morning and you try to go to work, your mind is going to be trapped into these thought processes and blaming mode or guilt mode or whatever. The point is this, it is that if you manage to create a deep sense of energetic and emotional safety in your couple, it's a quality or it's a skill that is very, very powerful to create connection. So what happens when you feel energetically and emotionally safe, there is this sense of, you know, peace and openness, your heart starts really blossoming, you feel like you're in this creative space where you can basically relax, chill, be in flow state. So as soon as you fear or there is a threat of an attack or a blame, of a criticism, you know, all that's this aggression energy that can be directed towards you, then your whole system is going to contract and tend to shut down. And you know, we are not saying about that it's wrong to be real and have emotions and so on. What I'm giving you here is the possibility that if you are within a tension zone in your relationship and it's becoming too much, or you feel that this is draining your relationship, that there is simply too much processing, there is too much fight, too much energy being directed towards that and sustaining this conflict and this friction, then it's literally possible to psych yourself up and make creating emotional safety a top priority for your couple. And the reason why I'm saying that is because I did experience it firsthand, and I've seen couples who master this really, really well. Basically, it's a decision. You know, you position yourself from the place where the way you look at your partner is from a place of wanting to create protection and safety for the two of you. And what happens is that every time you see a trigger zone or you see a potential fighting hook or a potential to go and deviate into trauma and processing mode, you just send a clear message. You say, I am not interested in having this fight. I want to be in harmony. I want to have fun. And I'm going to access the powers inside of me to stay in that state with you. I love you. I respect you. I'm not interested in fighting with you. Are we in? Okay. So if just one of the partners is into it, of course, it's going to be challenging if the other person is willing to fight and engage all the time. But if two people make that commitment, and each time you start engaging into something that might become a trigger or a fight or a tension, you just consciously go like, let's drop it. It's not important. It's not relevant. I'm not interested in having a fight with you. I want to be in harmony with you. Are we in, or are we in sync with that target or that agenda? And you might feel that, you know, it's a little bit maybe too much framing, that it's nice to be spontaneous and free, and even if you're on a romantic date, to, you know, to enter into trigger zone and all that stuff, you know, create the friction and the tension, because sometimes it's what makes you feel alive, you know, just be spontaneous and express your feelings without filters. If you are triggered or you're angry, you just go for it. And the point is this, it is that, for instance, imagine that you would be trying to have a business with somebody, right? And you are with that person and you really need to have harmony to be able to create. If that person on the desk next to you is attacking you all the time or blasting you, it's impossible to function. And the same with lots of things in life. So the tension that you build up when you're in a fight mode, and that creates a lot of stress in your system that eventually accumulates and creates, you know, lots of negative side effects. So my belief or my experience both in my own life and with coaching people on that topic, it is that it's possible to make emotional safety, peace and harmony in your couple a top priority. So it's almost like, yeah, you can call it a pact of non-aggression in your couple. And I do believe that it should be, you know, to a certain extent, part of the marriage ceremony. You know, who says that it's okay after 10, 20 years of being married with that person and having opened all your life and all your love and having fed each other, and then suddenly you end up in court in this massive court battle that drains your emotional and financial resources. It's just crazy. It's really crazy to think about it that way. And so you could have a setup where you decide before you even enter into the couple that, yeah, this is my top priority. I want you to feel safe when you're in my presence. I don't intend to attack you when you come back home tired from work. I'm not interested in making your life a misery. I'm not interested in playing that kind of role for you. So this prioritizing it is really something that you can consciously do. And the moment you start doing that, you will notice that it does shift the vibration, the frequency in the relationship. And, you know, if at that point, once you have safety and you have peace, you go like, well, actually, I'm getting a bit bored in this relationship. There is not enough action happening. Then ask yourself, how can you bring more action and more energy with that and entering into a conflicting and friction mode with your partner without having to go into trigger mode to feel alive? You know, this is a very important question. I don't want to challenge you or confront you with that, but if this is what you're doing in your relationship, that you are entering into trigger mode just to feel excited about something, then of course, you know, you can question that and what am I doing? You know, there are other ways to create excitement and challenge and energy without having to, you know, attack and wrestle with each other. Makes sense, right? If you have any questions on that, post in the comments, give me your reflections. Is this something that you have been experiencing in the past? You know, what was the shift when you decide consciously not to be in fighting mode with your lover, partner, your boyfriend, girlfriend, with your husband or wife? You know, what have you been able to modulate that to fine-tune this relationship so that you simply bring peace and harmony into your couple? What's your experience? Are you able to do it? Do you wish you were able to establish that kind of energetic contract with your partner to create safety? These are really good questions. And again, try to imagine what life would be like if you arrive in your home and it feels really safe. It feels safe all the time. If a trigger shows up, your partner comes and says something like, there's something that has been emerging over the last few days and I feel a little bit challenged with that. When is a good time for us to do a check-in? A shadow check. Okay, you see that there is no charge in that. It's not an attack. It's like, I'm feeling a bit challenged and I don't know what to do about it. Would love to have your insights or your help on that. So creating this sense of peace and safety in your home is something that can radically change, shift the way you lead your life. I hope that makes sense. I love you.